Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Michelle Reitler, and you may have heard my voice before, but I'm going to walk you through how to sign on to Moodle if you haven't done so with your child yet for the Flex courses. So you would just go into, if I log out, you'll see what it looks like. And if my emails pop up, I apologize. So you just click on log in here. And you should have received an email with your child's username and password. So you go ahead and type it in there, put in the password, and you can say remember the username. That's generally not a problem, but if you are planning to go to other computers, like if you're planning to go to the library and say, hey, why don't you go work on your science, you may want to have them type it several times so that they can remember their password more accurately. It's a problem that I run into with my high school students regularly, and it's a good habit to instill is to keep practicing with your password every now and then to make sure you remember it. So anyway, I'm going to go ahead and log in, and my classes are going to look a lot different because I'm in just about every class in Moodle, so bear with me. So the first thing you're going to do, I'm going to ignore those messages for now. First thing you'll see is a list of due dates over here on the calendar, and that mostly relates to the high school students. So you don't generally need to pay too much attention to these because there will be a calendar inside of your program, inside of your Flex course. So those are the ones that you need to pay attention to, and there's two places where you'll find that. There is a great tutorial right here that Laura Evanowski, our Moodle manager, has posted. Feel free to take a look at it. It's really good. It's really helpful. If you want your child to edit his or her profile, this is pretty common. Most students pick it up intuitively because if they do things like Facebook or they do IMVU or things like that, where they change their icons and their avatars and things like that, it's exactly the same process. So they don't necessarily have to have a picture of them, but it's nice to see something other than an outline of a head as the icon. So I saw that one student already put a Mega Man in there. That was pretty awesome, especially since it was 8-bit style, so that was pretty cool. Okay, so feel free to take a look at these. These are available at all times, so you're welcome to look at them at any time. So we're going to go to the navigation, and like I said, your courses are going to look different than mine. So you hover over the navigation bar, and then you highlight My Courses. And you can see here I've got quite a lot of them. But the ones that you're going to be interested in are either Science 8B or Science 7B, since we're starting in the spring semester. If you were in fall semester, it'd be 8A or 7A. So I'm going to go into Science 8B. So here's a general introductory to my class, and there will be a video. This video will be posted right below the little corgi picture, but obviously it's not there yet because I'm recording it now. And you'll see that it's just got a general welcome. It lets you know what my work hours are. I'm a half-time employee at IDEA, so the other thing is office hours. This will take you to office hours here, and that will bring you to an iLink. Office hours are Wednesdays and Thursdays at 11 p.m. or 11 a.m. sorry, Mountain Time. So if you're on Pacific Time, if you're up north, it's 10 a.m. Mountain Time. But I figure if I do it 2 days back to back, I'll catch you if you have lessons on one day and not the other. So in here, in the class informations and resources, I'm going to close all the toggles first, and you can see the toggles, other than the first one, are listed by date. So you can tell what the closing date for the assignments are just by the toggle title. So that's pretty easy to and clear, and I've got everything set out by week. If you take a look at the class information and resources, you're going to spend a lot of time here. Here's the syllabus, and the syllabus is the same syllabus as on the website. Here's an office hours link. It's the same one as this link. It's just linked in multiple places because if I list it as office hours and then I refer to it, Moodle will automatically take the same link, which is nice. So that's that. Now, here's where you're going to spend some time, the online textbooks and chapters for download. So I'm going to open that up for you. And you can see here that I have two flavors. So I've got EPUB files, and I've got PDF chapters. If you have an iPad, an iPod, a Nook, or an Android device, you can download the EPUB files. And the EPUB files are fully functional internally. That means that if it's got a video link, it'll work right there on the EPUB file, and you don't have to link out externally. If you don't have one of those devices or don't feel comfortable downloading an EPUB onto your iPad, iPod, Nook, or Android device, you can use the PDF chapters. And the PDF chapters are all right here. It's the same exact chapters in the glossary. And you're just going to download them to whatever device you're using for your child's science. The video links, I say, are disabled. In other words, they won't play on the PDF because the PDF is a static document. However, if you're using it on an interactive device like a computer or an iPad, you can click on the link above the listing for the picture and it will take you to YouTube and it will play it for you. Just be aware that if you are using YouTube in certain public areas, some libraries block it, for example. If you have your student dual enrolled at a school and they have a day off, most schools block YouTube. So just be aware that they may not be able to access that video content if they're at a library or at a school location. So we're going to close those, but you can get to them easily. And I highly recommend if you have those devices, definitely use the EPUB files. It's a lot easier, it's more interactive, and I think you'll enjoy it more. And then you just click on this one if you're going to do the EPUBs. The PDFs are easy. It's just a download. It's a normal thing. It's like downloading a document off of email. But this one is a little bit different. It says, how do I add an EPUB file to my device? Okay, and that's a step-by-step instruction for each one of these applications up here. So that's how you do that. And by the way, you won't have the edit buttons and things like that that I do, so just be aware of that. And the instructions for each one is always listed up here in this box below the title. No matter what activity you're in, there will always be instructions and it will always be up here in this box, just so that you're aware of that. Okay, so let's go back to the class and I just click on the breadcrumbs trail, which is what this is called. I just click on the breadcrumbs trail to take me right back out to my class. So I go up here, I'm going to close that toggle. And we're going to look at this week's toggle. And you can see that I've directed the children to read two sections, 12.1 and 12.2. So they're going to cover work and machines. And when they go into the worksheet, what this icon means is it's a quiz. And that doesn't mean that your child's being tested, it just means that that's the type of module that Moodle has. And that's just the name of it. So it's not a quiz. It's open book. They can, it's just one of those, they can come back to it kind of things. So I'm going to click on the 12.2 worksheet, and you can see that there's a one attempt allowed. Now, this is always the same instructions for each one. This book is open book and open notes. There's no time limit. Please complete these questions regarding the section you've just read. Now, I want to make a point here, and this is very, very important, so please make sure that you are aware of this. Make sure that that your child knows that when they are clicking on the quiz, if they get back out, it locks them out, and then I have to go in and delete their attempt, and they have to start over. I'd really, really recommend that the first couple of quizzes until your child gets used to that system and clicking submit, that you sit with your child while they are taking their first cup doing their first couple of worksheets, because I don't want you to get confused and upset, especially if it's on a Sunday night, if you waited till the last nanosecond to do that. So just be aware. Please don't leave the quiz module because you can't get back in until I go in there and fix it for you. And if it's the last day, I'm probably not going to get that email in time. The other thing is I can't extend due dates because of the way the quiz modules work. So that means that you need to make sure that your child is working consistently. If for some reason you're going out of town, for example, then you need to work forward. You need to work ahead. So I'm going to show you what the quiz looks like. It's very simple. Yes, I know. So you say, yes, I want to start. And here's the quiz questions. You can see that there's seven questions, and they're exactly the same questions and in exactly the same order as the book has it. So when they have their book open and they're looking at it, and what I'd recommend is splitting your screen by taking it like this, making it smaller. You don't need to see my Yahoo. And then taking things like my inbox. But let's say this is your book. So here's your book, and here's your quiz. And you can move the bar over here on the quiz so you can see the questions. And then you can kind of make sure that you're looking at it, especially, or if they're using an iPad device, that's going to be a little harder to switch back and forth, but it can be done. They just may want to make notes to themselves on the questions because they are exactly the same questions. The only time the questions are different is if it didn't make sense to put into Moodle. The reason why I say that is because there's a couple of questions I've seen so far that say, like, draw a diagram that does this. And that would be silly to put in there. So I'm not going to have them do those types of questions, but everything else is reproduced faithfully. So once your child has answered them, and by the way, some parents are very particular in how their child answers questions for them when they're grading them. I will explain that with my grading, if you can answer it in bullet points or you can answer it in single words, even in some of them it is a single word answer, you don't have to write a complete sentence if you don't want to. That being said, if that's how you're trained, that's fine. You can do it, but I don't require it. So just so you know, I'm not looking for complete sentences or essays or anything like that. I'm looking for simple, what I call sports reporting types of answers. And what I mean by sports reporting, if you've ever watched professional sports and they've got the announcers sitting over on the sidelines or up in the booth, they basically say, "See that? So did I. Back to you, Bob." And that's really all I want your child to do, is to say, "Here's what it is," or "Here's what I think it is," and go on. I don't need, "Here's what it is, and here's how Mrs. Pettypans did her picnic in the park," because we don't need all that additional information as long as they've answered it completely. Okay, so these questions are going to take a little bit of time getting used to because the child's usually not used to probably typing in a box like this. But you can see there's all the same icons as you have on Word, and you're welcome to. You can see here that you can paste from Word. So if your child wants to do a Word document and answer the questions first and then just copy paste, that's fine. It just depends on the individual child's working style. Okay, a note on grading. All quizzes are worth 10 points, which means all worksheets are worth 10 points. And there's a lot of worksheets because there's one for every section. I grade on Mondays and Fridays. That means that because you have until Sunday to catch it, so if I grade on Monday, I'll catch what you finished over the weekend, and I grade on Friday, and then I'll catch whatever you did. Ooh, I got a reload. That'll catch whatever you did during the week prior to Friday. So that's kind of how I grade. So I will catch it, but once we've passed that date, so let's say it's now February 11th, Monday, February 11th, and I've graded these two quizzes here, 12.1 and 12.2, and their due date is now over, I don't look back at them because the quizzes, the worksheets are closed. And so, anything that's not in there gets a zero. But each one is worth 10 points, and you can see that most weeks either have two or three sections to read. There is, however, in each quarter, and I'll find it here in a second. Ah, there it is. In each quarter, in each class, there is a portfolio assignment. Now, in physical science, both of those portfolio assignments are labs with accompanying lab write-ups. And I highly recommend before you start working on the lab write-up that you meet me during office hours once you've started on your experiment or started looking at the experiment, and come meet with me on office hours so I can walk you through the procedure of filling that out because it's probably unfamiliar to you. So, just so you're aware, that's something that I highly recommend you do. But because they're labs, each of these labs takes less than an hour to complete. And then I estimate another hour to write up. So with that in mind, you still have 3 hours of science for this for the week. So that means that I'm going to assign a section to read and a worksheet. So that's actually kind of a lighter week. But I will tell you that the portfolio assignments, regardless of which class you're in, count 100 points. So they are very important. So if you get nervous about things like that and you want me to check them over ahead of time, then do them early. Because if I receive them by the Sunday before they're due, so in other words, I'd have to receive it by March 3rd, I will what's called pre-grade it and send it back to you. And that means that I'll look it over, make, give you a graded rubric, and the rubric is in the folder, okay? I'll give you back your graded rubric, and you can make corrections to it before you submit it in Moodle. So you'll be emailing it if you want it pre-graded. And I don't keep, well, I'll record those grades in case something happens and you don't get to it and you don't get it submitted in Moodle. I've at least pre-graded it and I've got that pre-grade in my gradebook. But I will replace it. If you fixed something on there, I will regrade it on the due date and then I will change that grade in the gradebook. A note on the gradebook though. When you are doing things in Moodle, sometimes the gradebook's here, and you can find it here in the settings, and it says grades. You don't have most of these settings, but you will have the grades function. So when you click on your grades, sometimes they don't percentage-wise come out accurate. You can see what you did on each individual worksheet or each individual portfolio project, but sometimes it's not accurate. I keep the accurate, the completely accurate, very well weighted gradebook in a separate location. I keep it, where I can get access to it at all times. So if you're ever concerned about your child's grades, just email me. If you email me after my work hours, I will get back to you the next morning. So you really don't have to worry about speed of response. And usually I'm pretty responsive while I'm working so that you can actually get access to me pretty quickly. Unless I'm doing office hours, then I don't answer emails at that time because I need to focus on the children asking me questions or the parents asking me questions. So that's basically the basics of what we're doing here. The first several worksheets in each class, so I think all the way through March 3rd in both classes, are already in there. I am slowly adding to that from the online textbooks. But it's a lengthy process and it's something that isn't done all at once because it takes quite a bit of time to get those worksheets in. So never work more than a month ahead because that's about how far out ahead of you I am as far as getting those questions in there for you. The quizzes are, or the quiz modules or the worksheets are set up, but they're not active yet. So just so you're aware. And also, I would highly recommend not clicking on a quiz to preview the questions because you already have the questions in your online textbook. And once you click into the quiz, you have to complete it, as I said before. Okay, that pretty much sums it up. If you have any questions, please feel free to call me at 208-589-9877 between 8 and 12 on a Mountain Time. So that's 7 and 11 Pacific time. Sorry, guys. And if you have any additional questions or want a different walkthrough, by all means, please join me on office hours. And you guys have a great day.